Hi everyone, hope you're doing well from wherever you're watching this channel, depending on your time zone. Now, Governor Natembeya is pushing for a political revolution in the Western region, and the Tawe movement is taking place in Western. It is spreading like bushfire across the Western region. At one point, we know what happened during a barrel function whereby Natembeya had attended and Moses Masika Wetangula was present. So it became so destructive. The function was really disrupted. Both Wetangula and Natembeya had to leave that scene so that the event can continue. And after that, yesterday, Gachagua somewhere in Kirinyaga was reacting to that incident. And yes, even us on this pipeline, we do not agree with what happened in that burial event because people have lost their beloved one. Why do you take such kind of politics to disrupt such a function when you need to go and consult and mourn with those who are bereaved? We don't agree. So to some extent, Gachagua, in his reaction, is saying that kind of behavior is retrogressive. I agree up to that point. It is retrogressive. But again, he goes further to say that maneno kama hayo ya kutupa mawe, mass action, kuchoma tile, kule ukikuyuni huwa wafanyi hivyo. Hawa wanaongea tu kwa mdomo na ulimi na akili. Na inaishia hapo. I wanted to listen to Gachagua. Then from there, we are going to destroy the lie in Gachagua's statement. Because this is half truth. Another half is lie. And that is what we are here to destroy. Listen to him shortly.
Ilikuwa shida. Lakini mkiwacha hiyo tabia, mkuja tukae pamoja. Sisi hatuna maneno. So what is happening in Bugoma is retrogressive. Watu waongee maneno peke yake, wasitupanie mawe. Hiyo ni tabia ambaye ni imepitwa na wakati. So we want to ask all Kenyans to solve their political differences peacefully. Watumie ulimi na mdomo kuongea na akili. Hii maneno ya kutupa mawe, kuchoma tairi, kuchoma mali, hiyo ni mambo ambaye haina haja. So lakini ni mzuri, at least tumeona siku hizi hakuna hiyo maneno ya maandamano, hakuna kutia sufuria kwa kichwa. Unajua ya kina mama wetu walienda hasara sana siku hiyo. Sababu watu wanachukua sufuria wakienda nayo inapotea kwa tia gas, wanachukua ingine inapotea. Akina mama naenda hasara. Na hiyo maneno sisi hapa Kikuyuni hatutaki hiyo maneno. Kadi mungu na ndio hiyo. Sisi tunaongeaga na mdomo, tunakubaliana, tunawachana na hiyo maneno. And now that you are afraid of Pastor JJ, atakuambia maneno ya kwetu vile tunakaanga hapa. But I'll invite you for a cup of tea. I would like you to tell me that good bang you are saying is which one. Ndiyo nierevuke. Because me, I'm not very intelligent. Najua mimi sijasoma sana. Sijui mambo mingi, so utanielemisha kidogo. Ndiyo nierevuke.
Gachagua is clear. Ukikuyuni huwa tunaongea na mdomo, tunaelewana na mambo inaisha. So mdomo ulimi na kuelewana mambo inaisha. How true is this? When we know very well that it is the same Gachagua who was in charge of this country when the Kenyatta's family Northland farm was invaded by goons organized by Gachagua. He was here. The invasion happened. He was silent. Those youth who went to that place to invade the land, they were carried in very expensive vehicles. We saw goats being stolen. Dopa goats. We saw trees being cut down. We saw land being subdivided. We saw goons seizing everything from that place. Is that what they refer to as talking and agreeing? What is the difference between this and what was happening in Bungoma? In fact, this is more worse than what we saw in Bungoma.
Hallelujah. Kuna woga.
Once again, just coming to you from the Eastern Bypass. This is Brian Mushiri of NTV, and we are right at the Northlands piece of land. This is the piece of land believed to be owned by the First Family, the former First Family, Mzee Jomo Kenyatta, leading down to former President Uhuru Kenyatta. What we have seen as of this moment is a group of young men and even women, like you can see that lady there, just making their way into the piece of land. They are actually taking it into inside the car right there, just seemingly dividing the piece of land to their own liking. And then now some level of vandalism has begun. Remember, this is the vast land owned by former First Family, the Kenyattas. You know this piece of land if you use the Eastern Bypass, right off Kamaki's, on your way to Ruai and throughout.
Now, as we continue with this particular discussion, just a quick request for those who are watching and who have not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing. To our return subscribers, I must say thank you so much. And again, to all our viewers, please give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much, and back to this discussion. Both the supporters of Wetangula and Governor George Natembeya went physically to some extent, which was bad, which we condemn. You have to agree or disagree without necessarily going physically. But we know in Kenyan politics there's a lot of drama. So yes, condemning this, we agree with Gachagua. But there is a narrative he's bringing there that Mount Kenya is clean. Such kind of politics do not happen in Mount Kenya region. That is a fat lie. You can compare what we played in the previous analysis about the issue in Trans-Nzoia, though he's saying Bungoma, but this was happening in Trans-Nzoia. Then compare that to what happened at Northland, belonging to the Kenyatta family. So if we can say that Natembeya organized goons, Wetangula also organized goons, then they were attacking each other. What about who organized goons to invade Northland? There was robbery, there was violence, because even the security were chased away. There was robbery, looting. They seized the land. They were subdividing it. They had some title deeds. Who gave them? They were cutting down the trees. And they took them away. So, if you organize for such kind of things to happen in Mount Kenya, Gachagua should not stand on any platform to lecture anyone about what happened in Bungoma. First of all, let him wash his hands clean by returning the goats back to Northland, because that's what people are saying now. Anyway, Gachagua is talking now today. The other time he was begging Mama Ngina Kenyatta for forgiveness. People are telling him, that is not enough. First of all, return the dopa goats. Rudisha kondoya wenyewe. Anaambiwa hivyo. So, even in public, perception is that Gachagua organized. Because he never came out to condemn that. And he has never come out to deny this. There is nothing like Mount Kenya region politics is clean and the Western region politics is dirty. In fact, what we see in Mount Kenya is so much dirty compared to what went through, what happened in Bungoma. Here, Mount Kenya is so much dirty. When you organize goons, gangsters, you know, this, they act like bandits. You know? But they were organized by politicians. In Bungoma, to some extent, these are Kenyans who are tired with some kind of politics that have been through under the leadership of Wetangula and Ford Kenya. Someone is trying to liberate their mind. Like in Harper, they organized looting. So we, mambo ya clean politics iko wapi? It was a lie. So Gachagua, as you won Bungoma, you won yourself also and the one people of Mount Kenya region. Because there's no difference here. You're turning by. But you would want to create a perception that huku Mount Kenya we have clean politics, huku wengi wako na dirty politics. No. He was saying so because he knew Eugene Wamalwa was present, Wajakoya was there. So he had to say so, and above all we understand Gachagua is suffering. He is in panic. He is in pain because he knows that the future politics is not going to favor him going forward. And that's why he had to say such kind of things. So far, Natembeya is still continuing with the movement, siasa ya maskini, and the Tawe movement is taking place and the situation is still going on. It is not yet over for Wetangula.
Kwa mwili ya Wetangula mwenyewe hakuna jeraha yoyote. Kama Wetangula ametairi yako na jeraha moja peke yake na inamsaidia yeye. Moja mbaya iko na uhusiano kubwa sana na mambo ya uongozi ambao tunachagua. Ile siku tutagundua hiyo siri, mambo yetu yatakuwa sawa sawa. Mambo ya ukabila haisaidii mtu akanashua yu haikusaidii chochote. Ukabila inafanya unachukia mwenzako bila sababu. Ukienda hospitali wakisema unataka kuwekewa damu, O positive ama ile yako. Wao wanauliza jamii yako.